All the fun of a snowmobile, boat, and airboat, all wrapped up into one. That's how Terry Chapman describes his hovercraft. At the age of 12, while some of his buddies were still playing with model airplanes, Terry built his first hovercraft. And now at age 18, he's on his fourth one. What is a hovercraft? How is it made? What does it do?
A hovercraft is defined as a vehicle which rides on a cushion of air between 6 and 18 inches above the ground. It goes over land, ice, snow, and water. One fan in front lifts it off the ground about 8 inches on my hovercraft, and then there's a 4-foot propeller in the back for thrust, which pushes air over directional rudders.
What makes this a better hobby than regular boating?
The biggest advantage for hovercraft is you never have to put it away for a season. You can run it year-round. And therefore, if you get a snowmobile, you can only, in this part of the country, you can only run it 2 or 3 months out of the year, if even that. Where this, you can use all summer and all winter and any part of the year.
We met Terry at a popular hover's nest for him and several other members of the Toledo chapter of the Hovercraft Club of America, Half Mile Creek, just over the Michigan line. In fact, it's a rally site. Right now, the members are gearing up for the national rally in June at Terre Haute, Indiana. The hovercraft's origin goes back to 1959 in England, and while its popularity is big in that country, it's only now starting to generate any real interest in the U.S. Terry took me for a spin in more ways than one, reaching the craft's top speed of around 60 miles an hour. Terry graduates from Swanton High this year and is planning to take up mechanical engineering at Ohio State. But he says he wouldn't mind designing and building hovercrafts for a living someday, if and when they become as big a fad as snowmobiles. The Soviets, who are always looking for military possibilities in just about anything, became interested in the hovercraft several years ago because of its amphibious capabilities and its potential in land assaults. The U.S., on the other hand, for budget reasons, has done very little with it. So, as you might expect, the Russians have a 5-year jump on us in development of the hovercraft. John O'Malley around the corner for 24 Eyewitness News.